ओके स्टूडेंट्स, सो वी लेट स्टार्ट्स विद आवर कंबाइंड वेलोसिटी ट्रायंगल डायग्राम फॉर द इंपल्स टर्बाइन. ओके सो फॉर योर रेफरेंस, सी दिस इनलेट वेलोसिटी एंड आउटलेट वेलोसिटी ट्रायंगल डायग्राम. ओके सो आई एम गोइंग टू कंबाइन नाउ. सो इट इज द कंबाइंड वेलोसिटी डायग्राम फॉर इंपल्स टर्बाइन. Okay, also remember that for solving the numerical rather than impulse turbine, they have to use the word the D-level turbine. Okay, so the word, always remember, this is the D-level turbine also. So rather than impulse turbine, they use the D-level turbine. So first, step by step, I'm told you procedure how to draw the combined velocity triangle diagram. So first, make horizontal line. Okay. So first you have to make one horizontal line, then draw horizontal line first and cut off AB. Okay, cut off as a VB. So first on the horizontal line you cut off the VB. Okay, I'm giving this numbering or the notification is A, B. That is the VB. First draw horizontal line. Okay, in numerical they have, suppose they given the blade velocity, they given if it is a 400 meter per second. Okay, so I have to take the proper scale. Suppose I'm considering it is a 1 centimeter is equal to 100 meter per second. So then how much dimension I'm taking on a scale for the VB? It is a 4 centimeter. Okay, suppose some students taking as a 1 centimeter is equal to 50 meter per second. Okay, what are we taking that scale according to how to draw the VB? Okay, suppose I am taking VB as a they given in numerical 400 meter per second. So I am taking scale as a 1 centimeter is equal to 100 meter per second. So according to scale I am draw it is a 4 centimeter. That is it, which indicates VB is 400 meter per second. So first make horizontal line, cut off as a AB, which indicates VB. Then draw BC line at an angle alpha. Draw BC line means at an angle alpha. So see here, it is the BC line which make an angle alpha. That is the nozzle angle. Suppose the nozzle angle given in the numerical, it is the 20 degree. Okay, so from B you have to make angle 20 degree. Make an line BC. Okay, on BC line we have to cut off as a V. Okay, in numerical if they given V, okay, the BC line indicates it is the absolute velocity, and we know that if you see here the absolute velocity make an angle, or that is a nozzle angle. From that nozzle angle we are going to strike or impinge the absolute velocity or the steam jet or the blade. So it is the BC, an angle alpha. So in numerical they given BC, they given alpha. From point B make an angle. Okay, on that line we have to cut off BC, which indicates absolute velocity V. Then we have to join line AC. Okay, join line AC, and from point C we make one perpendicular line. Okay, see, I'm giving the notification, it is the E. When we join AC, which indicates the relative velocity at inlet, from point C we make perpendicular line which indicates the velocity of flow. Okay, so again repeat, first draw AB line, that is VB line, according to proper scale. From point B make an angle alpha. Okay, on that BC line we are going to cut off, that is absolute velocity V. Okay, once you've done it, we have to join AC, and from point C we have to make perpendicular line, because we know the vertical component is C here, vertical component is VF. Okay, and the relative velocity v r. Okay, and so inlet blade angle with the velocity, relative velocity, you know that is the inlet blade angle, that is the theta. Now I am going to overlap on that inlet velocity triangle diagram, that is the outlet velocity triangle diagram. So I am going to change the ink color. Okay, once you complete inlet velocity triangle diagram, then it's very simple to draw the outlet velocity triangle diagram. Okay, draw line now AD. Okay, from A, draw line AD at an angle phi. At an angle phi. So what does that mean? Indicates angle phi. It is the outlet blade angle, which is outlet blade angle. Okay, draw line AD at angle phi, which is the relative velocity at outlet. Okay, then how to calculate VR1 and VR when we take the one numerical? Okay, in next video, so we can easily understood. First, we have to understood how to draw all the process at angle, at point A, make an angle phi. Okay, it is the outlet blade angle. Okay, from point D, again, we have to join BD. From point D, make perpendicular line. Okay, so give notification, it is F. Okay, it is the outlet velocity of flow. So outlet velocity flow, VF1. Okay, and this is the absolute velocity at outlet. This is 1. So for at outlet, I use the notification at suffix 111. Okay, if you refer any books, according to some books, it is put as inlet, I, and outlet use at is suffix at O. Okay, this is our notifications. Okay, so see here, now the two terms are remaining now, which are whirl velocities. Okay, we are going to cover blade velocity, we have to going to cover absolute velocity, we have to going to cover the relative velocity, we have to cover velocity of flow. Okay, now the term, remaining term, is the whirl velocity. So the distance from B to E, which indicates the distance B, which indicates the whirl velocity at inlet, and the distance BF, which is indicates the whirl velocity at outlet. So this is the procedure. I again revise in short. The first, draw VB according to proper scale. From point B, make an angle alpha. Okay, on that line BC, we have to cut off absolute velocity V. This is the main thing. Then you have to just join AC. From point C, we have to make perpendicular line. Okay, so which indicates perpendicular line is the velocity of flow. When you join AC, which indicates relative velocity. Once you join AC, you can directly get that inlet blade angle. There's no need to calculate. Okay, so we can directly, when you once join AC, that we measure that angle, that is the inlet blade angle. Okay, from point A, if they mention, if they give an outlet velocity triangle, outlet blade angle, that is a phi, make an angle phi from A. On that line, I have to cut off AD, which indicates relative velocity at outlet. From point D, make the join at point B, and from point D, make the line perpendicular, which is F. You measure distance after completing diagram, you have to measure distance BE, which is whirl velocity at inlet. We have to measure BF distance, which indicates whirl velocity at outlet. So this is the our combined velocity triangle diagram for impulse turbine. It is also called as a D-level turbine also. Thank you.